You want to take it from the top?
Yeah, let's try it.
I have heard somewhere that alpha males are being better in getting hot chicks, but it's not so. Have you seen Titanic? She was a bomb, sex bomb, beautiful, and the hero was Shosho. We are carrying our genes in our balls, and we have to spread that. You have to select the type of girl you want. Caring, loving, sex bomb, hot.
I'm gonna take out my dick and put it on a chicken.
Like the sweet cuddles, but I also like to bend a boy, not a man, a boy, over and pound him while he calls me dad.
I'm just losing the will to freaking live.
So at this point, you're fully turned on. Are you touching yourself? Are you having this conversation?
Bullshit! Where's my bullshit costume? I don't have it with me right now.
You're going to have to face retribution.
The intergalactic, interdimensional, multiverse judgment of the big guy. The kahuna, the maker, the master.
Man, look. The blessing.
Bro, the
Most High is not the end, man.
Welcome to War Mode.
That's it.
It's game over! You piece of filth! Family show, but I'm just gonna say it. It's game over, motherfucker! You goddamn piece of shit! You New World Order piece of trash! You eugenicist garbage! Excuse me. Excuse me, to take the Lord's name in vain. I apologize, but God forgives me.
And enjoy your life, my dear friends.
What would I have done?
Yeah.
I would have done a legitimate investigation to find out what exactly happened on 9/11. How did they know who did this so quickly like they did Lee Harvey Oswald?
Who's going to investigate the investigators? Who's going to investigate the prosecutors? Who's going to hold them accountable? Who's going to hold us public officials accountable? And that's all we're trying to do here, in addition to trying to find the truth.
Do you honestly and truly in your heart believe that Sandy Hook actually happened? Yes or no?
No.
All right, number two.
And I'm here to tell you, 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms.
Because you're in jail.
Secretary Clinton.
It's only just begun.
Back in the fucking saddle. Yeah, so you still haven't listened to the audio of Heather McDonald falling?
Oh no, you want to play for it?
You're going to fucking want to die when you hear this.
I mean to brag, I don't care, but I want you to know, double vaxxed, booster, flu shot, and I'm going to be honest, I have the shingle shot too. And I still get my period. What? Yes! Traveled, went to Mexico twice, did shows, meet and greets, never got COVID. Clearly, Jesus loves me the most. Seriously. So nice.
Jesus fucking Christ, dude.
Yeah.
I think she gave herself a stroke when she had that woo.
Yeah, dude, but that is not that much effort to get a fucking stroke out,
that's
heart attack,
wild,
whatever the fuck
dude.
That was. And she's like now monetizing it on YouTube.
What, that clip?
Obviously, yeah.
Oh, that's her clip?
That's her clip. Yeah, she put it up on YouTube.
Yeah, all right.
And she just claims like, oh, yeah, I don't know what that was about.
Yeah, who the fuck knows, dude?
She's
probably on a ton of meds.
They have to be, dude.
She sounds like she has dentures or something.
She sounds like Nancy Pelosi, slurring and shit. I didn't know if that was like because she was about
to. She might be drunk, you know, these comedians.
Yeah, good point. They are booze bags.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but your boy's fucking out. John Luke Brunel dead.
Not my boy, first of all. Yeah. Don't do that.
What was like his, like where did he start out? Like, how did he, like, Epstein's
just
a fucking...
jump right in. Yeah. Jump right in.
Obviously.
All right.
Because he was Epstein's boy, right?
It's Epstein's boy, but Ghislaine introduced him.
Okay.
I have, like, a whole fucking theory about this. Remember when I was telling you, like, Ghislaine's the one with the money from her dad.
Yeah, yeah.
Who worked for Mossad.
Mm-hmm.
And then this dude, French, air quotes, his real name is something fucking weird, Benchamol.
Luke Brunel's real name's Benchamol?
Yeah, it's a fucking crypto name.
Yeah, obviously.
French, but he comes from North African Jewish descent. His dad made a fortune in real estate, so him and his brother are just fully on the neats from the gate.
Yeah.
He had a ton of model agencies. One of them, he was in trouble back in the 80s. So they did a whole thing in the 80s where they had girls on Diane Sawyer saying, like, it was a fucking meat market. He would send girls that were, like, they're of age. These girls are of age. Yeah. Would send them to parties.
And what's Diane Sawyer?
Oh, she was, like, a Barbara Walters type.
Okay, okay. I got you.
Yeah. But... for CBS, pretty much like 60 Minutes. That's CIA.
Yeah.
Straight off the bat. But it was like the Karen modeling agency.
That was his.
That was the name of it, out of Tel Aviv.
Mm-hmm.
Masters of human trafficking.
Yeah.
As you well know.
Yeah.
And he would send chicks to parties, be like, send a couple girls, a couple of his models to a dinner. And the dudes were just picking them like they're at a brothel. You're like, I'll take that one.
Yeah.
And if you don't go with the guy, the girls are saying it straight up to Diane Sawyer. This is back in the 80s, so, like, you know, it was a different era of feminism.
Yeah, yeah.
But they were like, yeah, if we don't go with them and go to bed with them, we don't get work. So this, yeah, and this dude's no slouch. He found some of the hotties that, you know, one of my early beats, Mila Jojovic from the Fifth Element.
Really?
she's from this dude's handiwork, so...
Dude,
yo, tip the hat. Thank you, bro. Yeah,
dude, I
Joan of Arc.
I just watched fucking Eyes Wide Shut for the first time last night or yesterday during the day.
Do you want to talk about that?
I can talk about all. It's all the fucking same, dude. If you're telling me he's doing this shit, like, that is fucking terrifying.
Well, Kubrick was a master of fucking symbolism.
Yeah,
and
I watched that like hungover, so like the scenes were like very fucking long. Like when that chick gets in the fucking when Nicole Kidman gets into my boy Bill's head, dude. That was the most vicious Poussard attack on someone's brain when she explains them how she saw that fucking Navy guy and would have fucking ended it all just to fuck him.
To a manlet, too.
To a
fucking manlet,
beast. Dude. That's Dr. Bill, dude. I watched that scene and I was like kind of hungover and I was just like, oh my God, dude. I couldn't even think of such atrocities.
Now, there's theories that is based on JFK Jr.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Yep.
Holy
dude, Kubrick
shit.
Was wild. And there was 25 minutes of that movie that they cut out.
I know, dude. That's when I was listening to True Geordie with Ike. They were telling me, like, what is that 25 minutes of? Because it seemed like when you finish that movie, you're like, fuck, dude. Like,
okay, well, I'll tell you. Eyes Wide Shut, I think Kubrick kind of knew it might have been his last hurrah.
Yeah.
Because it was filmed at a Rothschild castle.
That was a Rothschild castle?
Where they had the masks.
Dude,
that whole ceremony.
That was insane.
That's all at a building that was built by the Rothschilds in England. Now, fucking...
That was in England?
In England. Okay. Kubrick loved the British. Was obsessed with... He was a bit of an Anglophile.
Yeah.
And he fucking... He knew where the bodies were buried, and he did all kinds of symbols, and he thought he could get away with it.
Yeah, I picked up on a few, like, watching the movie, but it's like every fucking scene, there's something going on with, like, this shit.
You gotta see 2001. So 2001 is a wild, alchemical fucking movie. It is like a standalone thing. And if you can get into the symbols, that it's just symbols.
I enjoyed that movie heavily. Like, that was a perfect amount of fucking like creepiness that I can fucking handle. That's no problem.
All of his movies are like this.
Dude. Yeah. I mean,
Shining, you might not be able to handle. Shining's fucking scary.
As long as there's no demons, dude, I'm good.
It's a daytime. Let's just do that.
That's right. Yeah, exactly. Daytime. I can watch movies during the day.
But 2001, straight off the bat, is just nothing but fucking symbolism. All about esoteric shit.
Jesus.
Like, I'm talking Francis Bacon level stuff, dude.
Yeah.
So it's crazy to watch, but what I was going to say was the last 25 minutes of that movie fucked people in the head because it was so wild.
Of Space Odyssey.
Yeah. Right? So if you're Kubrick, and then that's like your, that's not his first movie, by the way.
Yeah.
But like that was his like first like opus.
Yeah, yeah.
after he had done, after he was fully enmeshed in the Kabbalah esoteric shit, right? Mm. Then if he knows he's making his last one, the last 25 minutes of 2001 is some secret shit. The last 25 minutes of Eyes Wide Shut was going to be like the key. And they fucking cut it
out. So it was like they said that's it was the last 25 of it?
I think. That's what I think.
And then they just put in that bullshit scene where he's sitting there explaining it everything makes no to sense, him. Yeah. That made,
it's a beat ending.
That infuriated me when I was watching it. Like, I was very fucking pissed off watching that.
Yeah. They edited that while he was dead. So he never saw it.
And then you think his whole deal was like, dude, I fucking
I think he was going to expose them. I think the last 25 minutes was going to be too, it was going to expose him too hard. And they might have killed him or, you know, sped up his death or whatnot.
They
could easily
do that. They had fucking heart attack guns in like the fucking 50s. So taking out some old director probably wouldn't be too hard.
Yeah, yeah. He was a chubby boy too.
Also, the other thing that fucked me up.
Probably 190 pounds at least.
Really? We don't got to get into that. So. The thing that fucked me up was watching that fucking scene where like he went in and the dude was dead and he had to visit him. I watched that, dude, and I got a little bit of whatever the fuck you're talking about. I was like, fucking A.
Like the psychic terror?
At some point, you're going to be sitting in a fucking bed dead, and there's going to be a bunch of people around you like, yeah, he's
dude, I freaked the fuck out. I freak out.
That was a fucking brutal scene.
There's almost nothing I can watch. I tried to watch this new Ben Stiller TV show, and it's a mind fuck. It's like it's a psychological thriller.
Yeah.
And like I'm watching it, and like I get a feeling.
Yep.
I get a feeling of fucking death that I do not like. And I think it's because I'm alone. I feel like if you're distracted by another person,
easily,
you're good. But
it's like an It's Coming feeling. It's like you're in the fucking water with a bunch of great white sharks that are just too deep for you to actually know where they're at, but you know they're under you.
I'm watching the scene in the show, and it's a fake world where the guy had a fucking brain implant. So obviously it's not going to happen to me, but you're going to get something, right?
Yeah.
The dude's in the mirror. And he gets a bloody nose and he starts coughing up blood and he can't stop it. And then he has a fucking freak out. And I'm just sitting there going like, because I watched my fucking mom deteriorate. She went through this.
Yeah.
And I saw the fear in her eyes.
Yeah.
Like I grew up with the fear, watching somebody be terrified of just her physical,
shell,
you know,
fucking
the earth suit. The earth suit's like, bro, we're taking off. Yeah. We're going to the next level.
Yeah. I just watched a video of a single organism cell dying. It was fucking crazy. The whole thing just starts fucking evaporating and falling apart.
The end of 2001 is like this.
Really?
Yeah. The one dude goes, he makes it. The crazy thing with 2001 is it's the Saturn moon matrix. But in the movie, he had to switch it to Jupiter because the special effects couldn't do the rings yet.
Are you serious?
Yeah, so they switched it to Jupiter. But if it was Saturn, people would be fucking... If everyone like watched this and it was Saturn...
flip the fuck out.
All my Saturn Storm Cube guys would be fucking losing their minds. Mecca, all that fucking
Saturn
shit.
Black Death Cult.
Black Cube, Security, Harvey Weinstein,
yeah.
Jeffrey Epstein. I mean, where do you want to go today?
Yeah, it's fucking, and it's all just because I watch fucking Eyes Wide Shut. I saw all this, and I talked to Tom about it, and Tom's like, dude, I haven't watched that in so long. If I watch that now, knowing what I know, it's probably fucking insane.
I know. When I was a kid, I watched 2001, and all I liked was the song.
Really?
And, like, they talk about, I was, like, 19 when I first saw it. They talk about it, though, back when it came out, like, people didn't know what it was about. But, like, it fucked people up. People were watching it, like,
just
on
confused.
Acid and stuff, just,
oh,
like,
my God.
Because you know it means something.
Yeah.
It's like a great work of art where you're like staring at it like, I get this,
yeah.
But I don't get this yet.
Yeah.
Like there's
you know it's sick.
Anything that's good has multiple levels of enjoyment.
Yeah.
And then when you're at the highest level, you can enjoy all of it. Like if you're Kubrick, you know all the symbols.
Yeah.
You're there. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah, that was just bad. Like knowing that that shit goes on because I was like reading the articles on like Jean-Luc Brunel and stuff and knowing that like there's chicks. Beautiful fucking women that deserve great men. And they have to go to these fucking things with these scumbag fucking rats.
Bombs. Sex bombs.
Sex bombs that want to kiss. And they have to go to these things with these fucking rats and just get hollowed out by a bunch of fucking demons, dude.
Yeah,
that's
dude.
A demonic weird. Those masks were creeping me the fuck out.
One thing I really remember from Eyes Wide Shut is when the girl's trying to get him out. She's like, you should go.
Oh,
like,
dude.
And she terrifying. Like put herself on the line.
Yes.
She sacrificed.
Yes.
Yeah.
She made the ultimate sacrifice for my boy Bill.
Mm, yeah.
Yeah, that was just that is a fucking terrifying movie and like you that seems like if I had to like think about like what elites are up to, like they're so far gone that like that's probably it. Like going around and like watching it's like going to a fucking dog a dog park.
That's what Jean-Luc Brunel was doing. He was setting up models to go to stuff.
Thousands.
And Well, Epstein claims he fucked 1,000 of the girls. Now, John Lou Brunel is the dude that's famous for getting Epstein the triplet 12-year-olds.
Yes.
And Epstein was bragging about how good the head was.
From a 12-year-old.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And you get in trouble for talking about this.
Uh-huh. Yeah, yeah.
So, but Brunel also raped a 12-year-old, right?
I'm sure. I mean, all these guys
did,
like,
got in trouble for raping 12-year-olds.
Dude, him and his boys, his one boy, I think his, I gotta look his name up. It's like Casablancas, John Casablancas. He's a dude that got Naomi Campbell started. And Naomi Campbell just dove into this.
She's got an island, right?
She's got an island. She got the Eye of Horus. She loves all this shit. That's so it's funny. Like, it's hit or miss. Some of these chicks dive straight into it.
Yeah, I mean, it's like a pyramid scheme. If you do, like, you can just fucking get a bunch of other people and make a fuckload of money off them.
Yeah, I mean, the main driving thing of the blackmail stuff that they do is, like, this is Operation Brownstone. So this is, like, there was a dude in the 80s, Barney Frank. He got busted. He got busted because he was paying gay prostitutes.
He got Barney busted. Frank. Why Barney does Frank. That name sound familiar?
I think he's a senator
is
or
he
congressman.
Is he related with Cohen and them?
No, he's, like, fucking, he's, like, a, he was a... like, pretty famous senator, congressman.
And he was buying boy pussy?
He was buying boy pussy down in D.C. in a brownstone. And the dude that did it, his name was Gobi, he sold his story to Penthouse. And he was like, fuck this. He was like, I'm not a prostitute. I run the place. And, like...
holy shit.
Yeah, so those guys get bought or whatever. I mean, it's all blackmail stuff. It's what Roy Cohn did.
That's it, Roy Cohn. I was
Trump,
thinking of.
Yeah, Trump grew up learning it off of him. Fucking... all these guys that have modeling agencies, they use it for blackmail, just like in Eyes Wide Shut where the chick gets the hot shot.
Yeah.
I mean, that's blackmail city. And then a Dr. Bill comes in. Now, yep. Dr. Bill's compromised.
Yes.
So you're just compromising in a whole situation where, like, you have information at your fingertips. You got all these motherfuckers that are in this situation by the balls. Everybody in the room is by
even
the balls.
I didn't think of that.
How about the... hey, man. How about the fucking... how about the scene where they're shooting pool?
Yeah.
And the dude's just like, yo, bro. You're fucked.
Yeah, you're fucking done.
Yeah.
I mean, dude, that, like, at that point, when I watch that movie and I look at fucking Hollywood, it's like, dude, anyone who's playing a major role, it's like, you're fucked.
Yeah, I mean,
like,
all these...
you've done some sort of fucking dirt. I don't trust... at this point, I don't trust fucking anyone, because everyone knew about fucking Harvey Weinstein. Everyone knew about Jean-Luc Brunel. Everyone knew about fucking Epstein.
Epstein hated Weinstein because he gave him one of his girls and he got fresh with her. Got rough, or, like, she didn't want it.
Yeah.
And, like, it was one of Epstein's favorites.
That is
And
fucked.
He was, like, he called Weinstein a pig. He was, like, they were going at each other.
This dude's bragging. He called Weinstein a pig. Like he must have been a monster if this dude's bragging about getting
I mean, he had to shoot his dick to get it hard. He had to inject. Weinstein had to inject something in his dick to get it hard. Epstein's got the egg. These dudes are jammed.
These are jammed fucking units.
They're not on SR.
Nah, they're fucking, they're spilling it all over the fucking place.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's, like... every human being in fucking Hollywood is compliant with this shit if this is how fucking obvious it was.
Ricky Gervais called him out.
And they all just fucking laughed.
They know what the fucking deal is. You saw Tom Hanks' face when Ricky Gervais did that thing. Why did the camera go to him? I don't know. White hats?
Dude, well, the weird thing is, like, you have, like, Weinstein, fucking Epstein, Jean-Luc Brunel, all these dudes are just getting iced now. Like, who the fuck is doing this?
I think what my theory is, Prince Andrew settled with Virginia.
Mm-hmm.
Virginia's agreed to play the game. So the Royals are like, yo, here's 16 mil. Do with it what you will.
Mm-hmm.
Prince Andrew's like, we're putting this to bed.
And now, like, Virginia Giuffre was like talking about, like, yeah, you fucking think, like, you guys are good. Like, Prince Andrew, you're going to start fucking sweating because Jean-Luc Brunel is going to put all you guys out because he's going to save his own ass. And that's immediate fucking kill.
So Epstein's dead. Ghislaine's in prison. Brunel versus Maxwell is a dangerous situation. So they just kill Brunel.
Yeah.
No cameras are on. 17 Again. Cameras, they're all off. He's Again. All by himself, hung himself.
Yeah.
Allegedly.
It's so odd. Like, the thing I was thinking about is it's so fucking obvious. Like, them doing this to Epstein and them doing this to fucking Brunel. It's so obvious that whatever the fuck they know... must be that bad where it's like, fuck it, kill him.
Also, like, too, they don't need him anymore.
Yeah.
They're doing cyber. They're heavy. You know, the Israelis have switched to cyber. The Russian-Israeli combo is like they're moved on. Like,
and this, you're fucked. Like, they don't even need a blackmail anymore. They can just put child porn on your fucking computer.
That's what I'm saying. So all this expense, fucking Terramar, all these cover operations, like, this is expensive shit.
Yeah.
And the sun's setting on them. If they still want to do this model blackmail, they got young bucks coming up like Rachel Chandler. You know, all these young photographers are ready to go. It's not like people are going to stop wanting to look at hot people in clothes.
Yeah.
So.
And dude, every fucking human being I've ever encountered who's a photographer is an absolute fucking creep. All those dudes like walk around Rittenhouse Square and fucking like ask girls to take pictures of them. They're all the weirdest fucking human beings I've ever seen in my life.
They're voyeurs, Bill.
Huh?
They're voyeurs.
They're not, dude.
They like to see life through the lens. The only cinematic
thing,
crop.
No, fuck them. The only thing they remind me of is a block of fucking cheese. Anytime I see them, all I think is like, you are a fucking block of cheese, you weird fuck.
Oh, that's a bizarre
every time I see a dude, just rotting cheese, you rats.
Yeah. Well, anyway, what I think it is that Ghislaine was the money, and then they can't just go and do it themselves. They have to bring in Epstein as like the face of it. So they got to find some dope to take the hit. They got to find some dope to have the island, to have his name on it. Some egomaniac that wants to have his name at the house.
Yeah.
And own him and his brother owned all these apartments. Now you're going to fucking shit. They were getting Brazilian models from 12 to 14. Jean-Luc Brunel was living at one place. So they would put four girls in each apartment. There was three apartments.
Yeah.
Hold on. It's at 301 East 66th Street. And that's where he lived. He lived with little girls. This is a grown fucking man.
In New York
that was living with 14-year-old girls. The cops were onto this dude.
Everyone is compliant.
The NYPD was like, you know, beat cops were like, dude, what the fuck is this dude doing? They were like investigating him. So
it's like True Detective though, because once you bring it up to your higher ups, that guy brings up it, like, it doesn't take that much. Everyone's like, dude, people would know, and like, you could like,
you gotta remember though, this dude's boys with Ehud Barak, former prime minister of Israel, who bought five cities in New York to do smart cities.
That's fucked.
So it's like New York's like completely gone.
It's destroyed.
Yeah, the Port Authority. We don't even have to get into Lake Cal. That's been what, 21 years?
For what?
Since 9/11.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Right. So I mean, I think Ghislaine was the money. I think Epstein was the face man. And Brunel worked through Tel Aviv. I don't know if you ever saw the picture of him wearing the little Israeli army hat.
No.
The picture of Brunel. But he got the visas and the passports, and he did all the IDs for them. So he was grabbing chicks from the Ukraine, Kiev, he was grabbing them from Brazil, grabbing them from Ecuador. He was doing all this shit and bringing like tons of chicks to modeling shows that were like underage. Like straight up underage girls, like teen models.
And they're tied in with Wexner.
Oh yeah, mega group.
Fuck.
Yeah, dude, it's wild.
I mean, dude, the fucking
it doesn't stop.
It should Victoria's Secret should have been blown the fuck up once it came out, the teen Victoria's Secret thing. Like, the fact that existed, shout out to them, because I was fucking 12, 13, but at the same
time, Wexner had monsters. Abercrombie and Fitch and Victoria's Secret.
So yeah, they're just fucking hollowing out dumbasses constantly.
Yeah, yeah. But Brunel, he was doing all the IDs and doing all the paperwork. That probably went through Tel Aviv. And I think it was 2000, early 2000s, he hooks up with Epstein financially to start MC Squared.
That was their modeling agency,
Their modeling agency. So he already had a couple of them. Mm. So he was like deep into the model game. And then he brought Epstein's money into it, which is really Ghislaine's money. And then they're running a whole new game with Epstein's girls. And he had a ton of procurers out there. But Brunel's basically just a procurer. He's like a Renfield.
He's like a pimp.
And then he has like sub-Renfields that are scouts. And they go to try to find troubled girls. And they did it in New York, Miami, and then Tel Aviv. But they never will mention the Tel Aviv one on the news, really.
Yeah. What a fucking disgusting profession, too. It's just like, find hot people and take pictures of them. You're literally just a bloodsucker.
Yeah. And it's like, you never know like where the buck stops, but it did go up to the royal family, because Mountbatten, Jimmy Savile,
yeah,
Prince Charles, Andrew, apparently they all love young Sniss.
I mean, fucking Savile was a necrophiliac.
Yeah, I mean, I get it. They're beautiful, but wait. Just wait.
Seriously.
Everyone grows up, dude. Just wait.
It's just, it's a weird.
Wait till they grow up and then say yes. The youngest one, you want to take a guess?
Six.
Nine.
Jesus Christ.
Dude. Epstein's team had to have, it's not even the youngest, it's one of the youngest.
Yeah, obviously. They're probably murdering children and sacrificing them in some weird fucking thing.
In some weird deposition, she said that she had her first children aborted at 12, paid for by Epstein's squad.
What?
Yeah.
Who?
I'll let you stew on that one.
Who?
The 9-year-old. Started at 9, and then by 12, she was having her first abortions.
Like, I couldn't think of a fucking death that would be fitting for these people. I hate them so fucking much.
I'm telling you, and Ghislaine and Victoria, or Ghislaine and Virginia, that was like number one and number two, allegedly. That's a story.
They were, you know, like friends?
Well,
they worked together.
She was like one of the older groomed ones.
Yeah.
Coming from Mar-a-Lago, by the way. So
Trump, you're not fucking, you're on my list now, so fuck you.
But yeah, dude, like, Ghislaine's probably the one setting up the abos.
The what?
The fucking abortions.
Oh, definitely, dude. Yeah. I mean, it's I drive by Planned Parenthood on 69th Street, and I just get fucking angry. Because, like, you got people in your face, like, they do good work. And it's like, dude, you know they're selling body parts out the back. You know, like, DHS and, like, the protective services, they're all fucking tied into these fucking super rich people. And they're just eyes wide shut and fucking chicks constantly.
Yeah, like, Brunel's his like trick was he was like Cosby. He liked to roofie chicks. He was known for that. And like all these dudes, like all these fucking model guys,
yeah,
they're like, yeah, I dabble a little bit. Yeah, I've had some problems. I've had to pay some people off. But Brunel, he's a fucking monster. So all these other dudes are like kind of not admitting, but like not legally admitting, but being like, yeah, dude, all right, I fucked these chicks. And then they're like, but that dude's a fucking psycho.
Yeah, he's way worse than I am. That must be, like, if you are, like, looking for a Renfield or a Procure and you have some psychopath like Brunel come in, people are probably licking their chops to get after this guy.
Yeah, dude, I was watching this thing on Netflix. It was Netflix or HBO or something like that. But it was called Tell Me Who I Am. It's about two twin brothers.
Yeah.
And the one brother gets in a car crash, loses all of his memory, right?
Mm.
And the other brother just goes, like, all right, dude, you're cool. Like, hang with me.
Yeah.
I'll show you pictures of people. I'll give you a rundown and we'll go about and we'll live our lives.
Yeah.
And they live their lives forever. And then like later on in life, their parents are getting old and they're dying. And the dad just goes, like the dad goes to the brothers like, dude, before I die, will you forgive me? And like the one brother that had the memory erased was like, yeah, you're good, dude.
Yeah.
And the other brother's like, I can't do it, dude. Fuck off.
Oh my God.
And the one twin's like, dude, what was that all about? And the guy's like, I don't want to talk about it. Then the mom dies. They go into that. Like, so these two brothers, they live in, like, we're talking British aristocrats.
Yeah.
Okay? So there's a main house, mm-hmm. and then there's a little house for the bros.
Field house.
Which is fucking sick. If you're twins and you got your own little house, I think that's cool. I would have enjoyed that.
That kid I know who was half Rockefeller, half DuPont had a pool house. It was sick.
Yeah, so these guys are living in the pool house, and then the brother that had his memory wiped finds his mother dead at the bottom of the stairs. And he's like, what the fuck? And like, as they're going through their shit,
yeah,
you know, so now both their parents are dead. Now they're going through the house. They had these weird rules where they weren't allowed in the house.
Oh, really?
Yeah, the dad was a bully. He was a bit of a monster.
Yeah, yeah.
But I mean, like, the brother that had his memory erased thought that was the extent of it. Like, that the dad was the bad one.
Yeah.
Mother, he goes in and he finds a picture of him and his brother naked with their heads cut off. Like, the picture.
Yeah, yeah, like, so you like, can see him.
Yeah, cut the heads off. And the brother's like, dude, what the fuck is this? So he takes it to his other brother. His other brother, just drops a cup of tea. Just like, whoa, oh, here we go,
God,
right?
Dude,
get this. So the mother used to masturbate them. The mother used to make them play with each other when they were like 9, 10 years old.
What?
Yeah. This is British aristocrats now.
Yeah, yeah.
Now we're talking the same stock of people that Princess Di comes from.
Yeah.
Prince Andrew, you know. Don't forget Prince Andrew's excuse for not being able to sweat and dancing that night was he was at Pizza Express. Don't forget that, bro.
Adrenochrome, yeah.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Pizza.
Obviously.
So anyway.
Never stops. There was a basement.
So these two brothers, the mom's just like, this is cool, and did that for a while with them. Then she would...
What do you mean she was, oh, like she would do that?
She would diddle them.
Yeah.
And then she would drive them to other people's houses, hang out for a while.
Like a live sex show.
And then she would leave and people would just, you know, she would bring them around. And then people could abuse these dudes. And it went on for 3 or 4 years.
At what age?
Like till they were 14.
Fuck, dude. And then you see those WikiLeaks where it's like these three people are coming over. They're going to be your entertainment in the hot tub.
The one dude says he got dropped off at a famous artist's house, and the artist started going down on him, and he was getting bigger. He was like 14. He was like, fuck this, dude. I don't want this, dude. And he just left.
Oh,
and that's how it stopped.
God, bro.
But these dudes are fucked because the one dude tried to save him from the memories.
Yeah.
And then the other dude was pissed off because when he had his memory loss and he woke up, the only person he recognized was his twin brother.
Yeah.
And he trusted him with his life. So now the only person he really knows and trusts in the world has been lying to him for 20-something years. So now he's paranoid as fuck. He doesn't know what's going on.
Oh, and this is real?
This is real. Yeah.
Holy shit.
But I'm just saying, like, This is the British fucking upper middle class.
They're sick fucks,
know,
dude.
Like, whatever the fuck that's called.
All, they're all sympathy. Everything is just absolutely gone. If you're like that fucking loaded, dude, like I have a hard chance believing that you have real feelings for humans.
Yeah, I mean, they've done a ton of studies. Like, you know, they lack empathy. The richer you get, like,
that's
you're just holding on to the materials. I'm not of this world, so it's like,
negative, dude. Fucking,
you know what I mean?
Take anything. You can bring me to zero. You can freeze my bank accounts for all I care.
We're just infinite awareness.
Yeah.
We're just 2 points on a fucking...
Dude, that's what, when I was watching Soft White Underbelly with the one chick that was like a lady pimp, she was like, dude, they used to put me and my cousins in a room, and when my mom was gone, the dad would fucking just say, all right, now you guys can play, and they would play naked in the room, and he would videotape it.
Yeah. Apparently, there's a lot of pedophiles out there.
Dude, there's a fuckload. Every time someone gets caught with this shit, it's like terabytes of fucking child porn.
Sad.
Yeah, I mean, it's just fucking disgusting. And like the fact that this is going to happen, it's going to get drowned out by the Ottawa protests and whatever the fuck else they got planned coming up.
Well, they pretty much have it wrapped up now because Ghislaine's in jail. Brunel is, he can't talk. And we don't know anybody lower than that. There's nobody in the news that's lower than that.
Yeah.
And then the upper people is, it stops at Andrew. The buck stops there. It doesn't go to the queen. But Princess Di knew about all this shit.
Yes.
They fucking killed her for it.
And the queen's going to die soon, too.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't see, like, I think the people that are coming up, like, it might, they might just, like, you get all these people on fucking heroin and shit like that. That's your Renfields right there. You can get these fucking brainless idiots to go procure chicks for you all day long. They'll grab them for fucking whatever. The whole country,
I mean,
on fucking opium.
They're probably getting paid. They don't even need Renfields. In some of these countries, like if you go to Eastern Europe, there's parents that are selling their kids.
It was in fucking Eyes Wide Shut, the rainbow fucking store.
They sold Epstein a girl named Nadia to be the pilot. Well, they sold her, and it's like they trained her to be a pilot, and they trained her to be a pilot at one of the same places that they trained the 9/11 hijackers. So that must have been a little bit of a, must have been like a Mossad hub.
That's fucking insane.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is fucked. Like, they literally just fucking destroy people's lives. Just to feel some warm fucking 12-year-old sniz. Like, just to feel that, whatever the fuck that is, you're going to ruin someone's entire life and any fucking chance they had of having kids or anything like that. Everything's going to be
fucked.
Oh,
you kill them. Because they're not... The person that they would have been is gone.
It's fucking
That's what sexual abuse does to people.
Yeah.
It puts them in a life of shame.
Yeah,
they feel dirty, they feel used, they feel worthless. Your self-worth is gone because you were just used on before you were at like your higher faculties in someone else's game.
Yeah.
You know, like in someone else's like little thing.
And those dudes are just fist bumping about getting head.
Oh yeah. Amazing head, yeah.
I mean, dude, it's obviously a huge fucking industry.
Yeah, like Andrew, it was wild that it got to Andrew, but it's like, dude, Clinton, Ehud Barak, who else? Like, what other giant fucking... They were using this to grab state leaders, secretaries of state, these kind of people.
Yeah.
You know, like, you're never going to hear about it. It's all wrapped up.
It'll never come. I mean, all these people are fucking cleaned up. They'll either go back underground or, like, at this point, I would assume if you're trafficking this hard, you have, like... litters of children that you're just making.
Yeah, I mean, they probably had to kill a ton of these. It's like John Luke Brunel saying that Epstein was bragging that he fucked 1,000 of John Luke Brunel's girls. You're telling
that's
me
so many people.
That's
dude.
So many. I mean, it's like that's bodies, that's numbers.
Yeah.
But like, who's counting? But
yeah,
if you think about it,
like 900.
They're never. You're never hearing from these people.
You can't
pay them all off, especially now with all this. All this coming out. If you know that Virginia Giuffre just got paid by the Royals you're going to pipe up and say, can I have some of that money? I got touched too. Silence, bro.
Yeah.
So where are they? They're probably underground.
Or they're all just getting fucking hot shots, like in fucking Eyes Wide Shut.
Yeah, I mean, if they're living three apartments, four at a time, cycling them out, and Brunel's just chilling there, and like, you know, this is all coming from an accountant. There's a girl that ran John Lou Brunel's accounts from 98 to 2003.
And she's speaking out about
this? She got like in some kind of a trial deposition. I was watching a Memory Hold. Remember Memory Hold from Reddit, from the Matthew Buddha stuff about Tom Hanks?
Yeah. It is fucking, this whole thing is fucking gross. And every human being that is in some sort of fucking higher office is compliant, like, because you know what's going on. Like, people should be going to the end of the world to stop this shit.
Well, who's paying for it? You know what I mean? Like, I'm saying, like, here's Maxwell, Robert Maxwell.
The governments.
Well, I'm like, saying which...
What the fuck?
Like, which ones? Because I'm saying, you know, you got New York, Miami, Tel Aviv, and then all of our senators have to say, you can't boycott Israel.
Yeah.
That's like, you know, they try to pass that law. I think the Supreme Court was like, yeah, fuck that, but...
Yeah, when they were trying to give Katrina relief in Louisiana or whatever.
Yeah, I don't think they're as powerful as they once were, because I think the blackmail is going away.
It has to be going away.
Yeah.
Because they're running out of fucking shit.
And everybody's kind of onto it. Like, everyone's kind of paranoid about...
Since 2016, like, yeah, they've been, like, fucking grabbing at straws to give fucking, smoke screens so you don't fucking pay attention to it. They tried to fucking demonize it, didn't fucking work, only made everyone fucking stronger. And then it's like COVID, whatever, like Epstein gets fucking locked up, COVID fucking happens, everything gets fucking wiped. That dude kills himself, Ghislaine Maxwell somehow goes to fucking jail. Not, you don't hear a fucking word about it. It's never on the news.
Her family's saying she's afraid for her life now.
She has to be, dude.
Yeah.
If they kill her, then like...
That could just be fake too.
Oh, yeah.
That could be like, oh, I'm so afraid, when it's like her and her family and their extended network that killed him.
I hope she gets fucking drugged, dude. I really do. It is crazy.
She might have put the hit out on him. She might have made a deal and was like, yeah, kill him. I'm good. I won't talk.
And that happened in Paris?
Yeah, he was locked up in France. He was being investigated, and he got caught being rough with a chick or something like that.
Dude.
Dude, he was knocking chicks out. He's Cosby. He's a roofer. He loves roofies.
Yeah. Roofer. Yeah, they're sick fucking tickets. And like, I really think I don't know like how the fuck this is going down, but it seems like something's coming to a fucking head with all these people fucking like, dude, this has been going on forever. Why all of a sudden are all these people getting locked up?
Yeah, I don't know.
It's a weirdest shit that like Harvey Weinstein, all these people are so out in the open, all this shit happened, and then
I mean, this is like this is a form of, you know, control or blackmail, though. And they, like, if you look at the Franklin scandal, some dude hit me up on Reddit saying that his boy lives across the street from Boys Town, and there's tunnels.
There's tunnels fucking everywhere. Yeah. Like, it makes sense to make them if you're going to be, like, moving four different girls in between houses all the time. People are fucking, they piss me the fuck off. They're so disgusting.
Yeah, I'm sorry to put you in a bad mood.
Dude. I'm not in a bad mood at all. I'm just fucking phased by this. This shit, like, after watching the creepiness, like, the shit you put out in the world terrorizing this fucking people, that's probably why I'm waking up angry. Because that fucking vibration is getting somewhere close to my fucking house, and I know that there's this shit's going on, and everyone wants to just ignore it, and everyone wants to fucking pay attention to what kind of new car they're getting. Check out my Jeep. Look at my Jeep. Let's get the new Jeep. All that shit, and no one gives a fuck.
Yeah, meanwhile, like, you know, in the spiritual realm, there's warfare.
I mean, dude, that is fucking insane. Like, if there's anything close to that, which obviously there is, the Biebs talked about it before. The Biebs said they tried to bring him in a room where they were fucking sacrificing someone, or that's a story that's out. And, like, dude, this shit is going on at these Hollywood parties. They're freaks. It's like, oh, what would you do with all that money? You get so bored. It's like, I know, you'd fucking somehow wind up sacrificing children because you're a fucking sociopath.
I mean, it's crazy that if you look at the moon landing and then you watch Space Odyssey, right, how closely that lines, like, when you watch it, you're like, oh, I'm watching the space landing. Fuck.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
If Eyes Wide Shut, if he made that, it's like, oh, this is what it is. There's rooms with everyone wearing masks. There's houses where everyone's wearing masks, and they all know who's who.
I mean, who was that? Michael Wan talking about the most dangerous game shit happened at the DuPont's estate?
Maybe. I don't know.
You were I think you were watching the, what was like a Higher Side Chats.
Oh, okay.
Like they were saying like all that old weird Delaware money, dude, like there's fucking.
Oh yeah, right. When he was talking about like the Golden Mile.
Yeah, they all like those weird hunting things they did in secession. Like they all go out hunting all fucking weird and shit. Like they're sick tickets. And like all around, like all their shit is just very fucking eerie. Like if you go into someone's house, so you can like kind of get a feeling for it, you start driving past all these estates and you're like, dude, there's weird shit going on here.
Yeah.
If like the only person you're going to let out of the cage is John Rockefeller, or what was his name? John DuPont, the fucking weird fox catcher weirdo.
Yeah.
So, dude, that's probably the tip of the iceberg. The dude just spurged on wrestling.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, oh yeah, he was crazy. Sorry about that. We'll just put him out there. Like I didn't know that his house was up where the Ellis Preserve is now.
Yeah,
that's a humongous fucking estate.
When I was a kid, that was all woods.
All that was woods.
All that was the DuPont Woods. It was really spooky because like you'd be driving by in the morning, you'd be like fogged.
It's terrifying.
And there's a big house, yeah.
And that's how there's a place, for people who are not familiar, there's a place called Devil's Road in PA. And I had a book on all PA's scariest places, and that's one of them. And then at the end of the house, it's a DuPont estate.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
That's like, it was one of the DuPont spots. But it's a fucking terrifying road where, like, in the very back, there's all sorts of weird stuff just sitting in a house. It's like, these people are fucking evil. If you can
sit there, Ike's been screaming about it for how long?
For fucking ever. Yeah. And, like, dude, it's crazy that the only thing they can do is say, like, oh, you're fucking crazy. That doesn't happen. It's like, okay, it doesn't happen, but people like Larry Nassar and Epstein exist. There's islands where pedophiles exist. But nah, it's only him. He's the only one who fucking does it.
It kind of makes it seem like that's the only purpose to really have an island.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You can go visit any island you want.
There's so many coasts, dude. Yeah. Hawaii's cool, but to have your own.
I guess if you want to have it and be totally private and everything. But it is a wild expense, you know what I mean?
It's the most infrastructure money you could possibly spend.
Building like a place.
Yeah, that's like the weird shit is like.
That you can't drive to.
If these people must be absolutely fucking retarded, because if you're Jeffrey Epstein, like he was on VH1's like Rich and Powerful and they did like a whole fucking thing on Jeffrey Epstein. It's like, bro, are you a fucking mongoloid? Like why the fuck would you put your business out there? And like for a while on Cribs, like MTV Cribs, it was like all people's houses out of nowhere. It's like Richard Branson fucking island. It's almost like free ads for these fucking weird pedos.
Yeah, maybe.
If they're fucking putting shit out there like that, like,
Who knows? Maybe there's some symbols going on. You never know. Like if you can read it all, it says something different to you.
It's a whole different world going on around you, and you fucking look like that's when all I could think about when I was watching Eyes Wide Shut is this is just a dog park.
And if they watch Eyes Wide Shut, they're watching a completely different movie.
Yeah.
You know, like it's deeper for them.
Yeah, it's like fucking the parents who watch SpongeBob and like get the adult jokes.
Exactly.
It's insane.
Yep.
And it's probably fucking sweet, but also like stop fucking kids.
Yeah, that's
like maybe like get better at tennis, like play water polo, yeah,
get ready for Wimbledon,
literally anything, golf more. Like, I don't know, like, I don't understand why it always winds up with these fucking elite freak shows being into fucking pedophilia.
I mean, that's just the elites, that's just the bad elites that we hear about. I'm sure there's some really good royals out
there. Well, that's what's like, I'm trying to figure out what the fuck, like, who is doing this, like, who's locking these fuckers up. Because you got all those guys from the NYPD who saw Anthony Weiner's laptop.
Well, nobody's locking up like the real guys.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like,
George H.W. Bush was ushering fucking kids from Boys Town into his house while he was in the White House. That's untouchable.
Yeah, I guess this is just an obvious fucking smokescreen. Just like everyone's going to be up in arms about the suicide, but everyone's going to be focused on that, not the fucking people who are still trafficking kids.
Yeah, it's not going to stop. Like I said, they got a young generation that were the mentees of the Casablancas and the Epsteins. Like, there's a whole bunch of people that you don't know about, you know?
Yeah, and then if you're...
And there's girls. Like, the main thing is the girls. Do you remember when we were watching the like, Limited Hangout one, where they were talking about, like, the 20-year-olds?
On Netflix, yeah.
And it's, like, those are the ones that, like, look cool, and they're, like, made models.
Yeah.
In a way, like, you don't know who they are, but they're, like, they're getting work. So the young girls, like, they simp to them, like, oh, I could be like that?
And they're, like, oh, my God. I couldn't imagine there was a version for that for dudes.
It would be like if NFL players were like, dude, Bill, you could be a tight end. You want to hang out with us?
Yeah, I know.
And you're like, let's play foosball. We're playing beer pong.
It's game over.
Yeah, that's what it is.
And you're up in Sandusky showers getting fucking wrestled.
Exactly.
It is.
You know what's crazy?
I feel bad for Bayes for that, dude, because fuck.
There's a lot of people that are connected to Epstein and this whole circle that work for like charities.
Oh yeah,
you know what I mean. This is where they
NGOs and shit.
Yeah, this is where they put their fingers in. And the crazy thing with the Ukraine and Putin is he kicked out the NGOs like back when Biden came.
Told me to get the fuck out of here.
Back when like Biden was VP and he was point man for Obama for foreign affairs.
Who was? Biden. Oh, Biden. Yeah.
Yeah, he was a point man. So it's like, and Putin was like, NGOs, get the fuck out of here.
Every single one of them are fucking wrapped up in dirt.
He knows what they're up to because he's a fucking a Russian KGB dude.
So yeah, like, he knows, definitely knows where the bodies are buried.
Yeah, like
he's running Russia. The whole world hates you. For what reason?
I mean, Jerusalem's not doing too much human trafficking without the Russians. No. They all come from Russia. Yeah. They're all of Russian descent.
Yep. It is fucking insane. The other thing that's nuts is like whatever the fuck they're doing over in China. Like whatever like they might have bad blackmail with these like Russian models and stuff, but like who knows what the fuck went on with like Hunter Biden over there on crack with Joe Biden, Rosemont Seneca. It's like, dude, what the fuck are you getting up to in China? Because you guys are literally imploding a country just so this shit doesn't come out. You're pushing a fucking fake virus for the past 3 years. To like do, you're doing the bidding of fucking China because you know they got you.
Yeah, I mean, Hunter's involved in this.
Hunter's involved in what?
Like, Hunter's connected to these guys, these modeling agencies.
No yellows.
That's what it is, yeah.
I mean, if he's that in on it, like, yeah, Hunter Biden is definitely involved. There's videos of there.
There's a ton of girls that are going along with this. Like, elite, I can't remember. I think it's called Elite Modeling. It's like Sharon Stone came out of that, Mila Jovovich, like. Dude. There's like legit, and they played the game, and they became movie stars.
Like, dude, if you're that hot and stuff, you're a queen bitch.
You can do
like,
what you want.
You're kind of like, yeah, fuck these dumb bitches. I'm gonna get money. Yeah, I like some people. They're so all these people are sociopaths. It's not like girls can't be. Sometimes it can.
I think these girls that take the younger ones and kind of like Renfield them are. They're like heavy sociopaths.
Oh yeah,
and narcissists. Dude. They're fucking whack jobs.
If you're running a modeling agency, you got people fawning over you constantly. Like, there's a good chance, like, you can kind of make everything right in your head because everyone fucking loves you.
Yeah.
Like, if you're hot sniz, dude, people are just happy to see you. Imagine that. Imagine you walk in somewhere and someone just like, God, here's Andrew. Holy shit! And like, they're trying to say jokes to you to make you smile.
Tell me about this world.
Could you imagine what kind of monster you would be if like everywhere you went, people are like asking you how you're doing and like joking around with you?
Instead of like, I meet people like five times and they're like, oh, hey, man. Like, what's this?
It is fucking insane. Like all these people, like all these elites and stuff, they're like. You can go one or two ways. You can just be a normal or like you fucking fall into all that stuff because you think you already start out like I'm a powerful part. I'm above all these people.
Yeah. I mean, I think that was the threat with Diana.
Yeah. Diana she was being like normal.
Yeah. And like before her, it was the queen. Like the queen had a really good PR team because she was the first one that like where she
queen
was like
Elizabeth.
Queen Elizabeth was like the first royal when there was like heavy visual media.
Yeah.
You know, and like they had other royals in that family back in like World War One that were like really cool and everybody liked like Downton Abbey era.
Yeah, yeah.
But she you know, they tried to make a little superstar out of her.
And then who was Seville the one who was Diana's husband?
Prince Charles.
And was Seville the one she had was doing the like get the back go-between. And forth?
Yeah.
That is absolutely
Lord Mountbatton
insane.
Like so Lord Mountbatton who got fucking iced by the IRA. Big ups.
Yeah. Way to go, boys.
He was like Prince Charles's mentor.
Yeah, dude.
So like, and then he was the one that introduced Savile to the queen. And Savile was like he was a big dude. Like Savage says he remembers and growing up, Jim will fix it. It's like a big deal. It was a big show. He was a famous fucking person. And he was doing charities. And like,
he was a radio fucking DJ. And he was hanging out with the fucking queen, dude.
Yeah, he was doing shit for kids, you know, like kids that had like major problems, like Make-A-Wish.
Yeah.
So he was like a Make-A-Wish guy, but really he was a necrophiliac pedophile.
Yeah, he was fucking volunteering to work in the fucking children's ward where all the dead bodies
were. Yeah, Jones used to have a great little montage of that.
Really?
Yeah. Because Jimmy Savile looked fucking nuts.
Yeah, he looks like a fucking dude clown. Who fucks dead children.
Yeah.
Like, if I had a guess, I would pick him every fucking
in a lineup,
time.
Yeah.
They're it's bizarre because I tried to explain this to my buddies forever ago once I started getting into like the rat lines and all this stuff and I'm like, dude, like Child Protective Services are scumbags and like I was like, Bill Gates is a scumbag, like how are they a scumbag? They do so much good work. So like you're getting 90% of the people to not even fucking believe you. If you look at a fucking normal person and tell them Child Protective Services rapes kids. They're like, dude, seek help. You're fucking crazy. Obviously not. So like you're only working with, like, by the time you finally like look into all this stuff, you're, yeah, it's such a small percentage. By the time you get to
Laura Silsby, I mean, you're fucking tapping out.
It's such a small percentage of people too, because everyone else is like, dude, I don't even want to hear that.
Yeah, most people just fucking live their lives, man.
It's a bad fucking feeling, bros. Yeah, I mean, yeah, that, like, I'm glad that dude's dead. I hope he fucking never comes back to this plane. But Jesus Christ, I want them all to die. After watching how they treat fucking the beautiful hot hotties and fucking Eyes Wide Shut, it's like, dude, I just want them to stop, please.
Yeah, you're watching that on high days, too.
Oh, my God, bro. Bro, Nicole Kidman is so hot. I was watching that fucked, dude. Like, every fucking time, it was just like a fucking heartbeat sensor. You ever see one of those?
Dude, when I was a little kid, she was, like, in every movie.
I
was like a little kid, it was like 2 years where it was like every fucking movie, her and Tom Cruise. They were married.
Were they really?
Oh yeah.
Holy shit, I didn't know.
Her husband and wife. They did Far and Away, Days of Thunder. Days of Thunder's nice.
What's Days of Thunder?
Days of Thunder's a fucking NASCAR guy. He goes blind.
Are you serious?
Oh, it's a wicked movie, yeah.
Yeah, that, like,
I mean, I'd have to rewatch it. My little me loved it.
Yeah, that movie fucked me. Watching that shit, I was like, holy shit, dude. Like, Nicole, like, I didn't, all I saw her was in Big Little Lies, so I was just like, oh yeah, she's,
oh really, yeah, she's fucked
I
now.
I don't watch any movies, so I saw this, I was like, A, Tom Cruise is the fucking man, B, Nicole Kidman's hot as tits.
Yeah,
she's very hot in that movie. Every fucking chick in that movie had me destroyed, probably because I'm in Days. I don't know yet. I know it's April 25th. It's the last day. That's about it.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. Like, the weird, like, itchy, I don't know, have any better words for it. Like, the itchy pacing of the Kubrick movies.
Yeah.
Where you're, like, kind of, like, all the time, like, with that.
How is this still going?
And when you watch The Shining, that's, like, peak.
Really?
Of that, yeah.
Yeah.
Even, like, Full Metal Jacket has it a little bit.
A little bit, yeah. Like, that scene where the dude shoots himself in the head in Full Metal Jacket, like, it draws out, like, to the point where you're, like, you feel fucking bizarre.
Yeah, like, Lolita's funny. Lolita's, like, so he did Spartacus. He did another movie I can't remember, but it's, like, World War II. And he did, Lolita in like 62, and he's making fun of them. He's mocking these dudes.
Are you serious?
That are into the young.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a very weird, because, like, it was weird because I was up until 4 and I fell asleep on my couch. I went up and took a shower. I was like, dude, I'm going to watch Eyes Wide Shut, because I always hear fucking people talk about it. And then the True Geordie podcast was talking about it. Sick podcast. And then I was like, all right, I'm just going to watch this. And, like, the last time I felt like that watching a movie was Fury.
Okay, yeah.
So I was watching, like, holy, like, that whole scene where they're fucking throwing the staff onto the ground and, like, they're fucking singing the song, the nightingales playing the fucking piano. That is a terrifying thing. That's what I would assume is, like, being on a bad trip of mushrooms, is being stuck in something like that. That's terrifying.
That would not be good, yeah.
Watching that movie fucked up is probably the scariest fucking thing in the world.
Yeah. It's crazy because all that, like, so the Rothschilds allegedly built that house. I wasn't there.
Yeah.
But they...
You never see construction.
Yeah. All that stuff, all that, like, symbolism in the construction, that goes way back. You can look at, like, old Renaissance paintings, like... There's a painting of John Dee. Like, there's a bunch of them with, like, that Masonic floor.
Oh, my God.
Like, dude,
God.
This shit's been going on for, like, 1,000 fucking years. And if you ever watch the Queen get coronated, you see a ton of this shit.
Masonic symbolism?
Yeah, go watch any of that. Any of the royals, when they go to that little church that they got, it's the same spot. It's literally
what little church?
I don't know what it's called. It's, like, where they do all their stuff.
Oh, they have, like a church where they do all their ceremonies?
Oh, they have their own, yeah. They have their own church, like, in the way, like, they have their own church, like, they have their own religion.
Religion, yeah. Yeah. That's insane.
But, like, their main thing where they have the stone, they have that one stone that's in the Robert Seffer video that they sit on. It comes from Scotland.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So it's, like, underneath the Queen's throne, there's, like, this special stone. They think it's from Egypt.
Dude, they
it's fucking sick. But I mean, if you look at the architecture, it's all the same shit. It's all the stuff from Eyes Wide Shut.
Yeah, they're literally.
So if the Rothschilds are building stuff to mimic it, this is, you know, York Masonry, whatever the fuck it is the high levels of the Freemasons.
Yeah.
And they know this weird Kabbalah esoteric shit, but they apparently use the magic for bad. So you can use, this is just higher levels of awareness. Yeah. So like when they carry out a hit, like when they took out Diana, there's a world of symbolism going on.
Really?
Oh yeah. Ike has a fucking whole video on it.
I'm gonna have to watch
it. Ike has like a, I know it's at least over half an hour of all the symbols, the times. Like they did, yeah. They do all this shit, man. That's like high level stuff that like the other elites are nodding their heads. They're watching the SpongeBob and they're getting the jokes. And the rest of us are just like, she died in a car crash.
Yeah, she was so hot.
And then when, if you know all this stuff and you watch it go down, you're like, holy shit, look what they did. That's what I'm saying. Like when they did 9/11, all the elites were like, that was like a ritual.
Oh my God.
That was
God,
like a fucking dude, bizarre yeah. ritual.
They were talking about that forever. Like since the fucking, I think it was Ike talking about it, since like the fucking like 40s or 30s or some shit. They're like, yeah, we're going to fucking destroy that. And they had some weird bullshit fucking lie. Like, oh, the Islam thought it was like a phallic symbol of America and they were going to take it down. Okay, perverts. Obviously not. Yeah. You weirdos exposed yourselves again.
Yeah. There's something that, like they try to push this thing like, maybe it's true. I don't know. But they try to push this thing where it's like, 9/11 was like the day they made peace between Israel and Egypt.
Really?
Yeah. And so the Arabs were like fuming about that.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Yeah. Who the fuck knows what went down on 9/11 and all that shit? You'll never know what the fuck got carried out that day.
Yeah.
You could have fucking slaughtered a small city and no one fucking know.
Yeah. Between the war games. And I mean, I can't wait till you watch all the stuff I was telling you about.
Oh my God.
And you get up to speed on 9/11. Yeah. It hurts me, bro. It's like the other day when you're like,
obviously,
the other day when you're like, oh, I never really got into any of this stuff. I'm like, dude, am I just talking into a fucking headset? Like, are you just fucking like, are you just taking the headset off and putting it on a seat when I'm ranting?
I know certain stuff, and certain stuff, I'm like, got it 100%, understand, but I'm saying all the little
shit.
But
when True Geordie says it, then you remember.
My boy Ike.
Then you remember.
I almost told the dude at the gym, which I'll get into something that happened to me at the gym today, and I don't know if this is like a brag, but I'll fucking talk about it on the Patreon. A little weird, but whatever. But I almost told the
I'm interested
the gym owner to watch the Dorian Yates True Geordie podcast, because that is one of the GOAT podcasts. If you're in bodybuilding, the first hour is bodybuilding heavy. Hey, I'm a fan. I admire the male physique in a non-homosexual manner. Guilty. Next 2 hours out are fucking GOAT.
Dude, I mean, to back you up, one time,
Dorian Yates' back looks like goddamn fucking toad.
One time I was all fucked up on drugs. I was like, yeah, man, it is cool that dudes build their bodies real strong.
Yes. Fucking, they would have made sculptures, dude. They would have made fucking pervert sculptures of huge dicks, but they were on high days. We're like, dude, you know what? Let's make fucking jack dudes because
fucking jack, bro.
That's powerful. If not, you make a fucking Jelaine Maxwell fucking thing. Have a huge set of tits.
Yeah, right.
I mean, they did. The funniest shit is the old, like, Robert Seffer goes into it. All the old sculptures, they were some high-day boys. It was nothing but big-ass women.
Yeah,
huge,
dude.
Fat women,
fuck
dude.
Fuck yeah, dude. All the sculptures, the little round ones.
Yeah, they're fucking amazing. Mm. Now look at us. We're all fucked.
It's just a bunch of Lizzos.
Because of Euphoria. They're trying to, like, push Euphoria like it's some goat shit. It's like pissing me off. They're like, this is the best show that was ever made. It's like, obviously not. Logan Paul podcast, he's on notice. They went in and like, I saw The Wire, I saw Game of Thrones, Euphoria is the best. It's like, dude, stop simping to the entire cast.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I was like, who's pushing this as a great show?
Ton of people are talking about like, oh wow, this is like next level, like there's long dialogues, it's crazy. It's like, no, nah, this is a fucking disgusting pervert show. The dude's from Bryn Mawr. Remember we looked into him? I don't know if we even talked about it on podcast. Probably did, obviously forget, probably say the same thing every fucking week, but fucking, like, that dude's from Bryn Mawr.
Yeah,
he's a fucking scumbag.
I remember this
little fucking pervert. Just imagine that. Imagine sitting in a fucking room and being like,
imagine pitching that as
that's
a
what
show.
I'm saying, like, hey guys, obviously, Cuties was a bit fucking ambitious, but how about high schoolers? They're fucking and doing drugs.
I mean, I think there was a movie that I saw about 10 years ago that had like a brothel of girls, and there were dudes that were like, you know, I think it was like a French movie, and there was dudes that were into knocking them out.
Yeah, definitely.
And, you know, I'm just saying, like, if you're an elite, if you do this, if you're Brunel and you're watching that movie, you're fucking stoked.
You're torqued.
They made a movie for you.
Yeah, you're absolutely torqued. You're me watching Nicole Kidman in her all-American beauty self.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, the other part's
she's Australian.
What?
She's Australian.
Like she? Oh yeah.
She's also connected to a pedophile ring.
Is she?
Yeah.
Just kidding. What about the one chick that was
her family? Her family apparently.
Oh
is,
yeah, fuck.
Yeah, man.
I take back everything I said. She's ugly. On the outside, yeah, she's symmetrical. Obviously, she's a beautiful woman. Obviously, but I don't know her like that, so obviously we wouldn't vibe. I was told I would vibe. I have a good vibe this weekend.
Oh, really? Okay.
I have a good vibe.
I like that. I like that.
All the people were on cocaine, though, so they could have just been lying.
Oh, okay.
It
sure.
Was, yeah, yeah. It was fucking very fucking funny. I'll talk about it on the Patreon, but yeah, it was just a very interesting. I heard some very depressing shit, and I watched some hilarious stuff, so yeah, we'll get into that on Patreon. I gotta think of a song. I don't know one.
I'll play a song from that French movie.
What French movie?
The one I was just talking about.
Oh, you just watched it?
No, I just remembered the movie, and then I remembered that sick song that was in it.
Okay, yeah. We can go French again. Yeah. I enjoy that. We'll roll over. And if you're a pedophile and you're listening to this,
go fuck yourself.
Heavily consider self-harm. Maybe kill yourself.
If you get the chance,
yeah,
you should probably kill yourself.
Do everyone a fucking favor. Jump off a fucking bridge or do something, but just make sure you're not near anything that can get fucked up.
Or don't harm yourself at all. We don't really mean any of that.
I mean everything I say. I never kid around.
Please don't hurt yourself.
So, whatever. Fuck you, John Luke Brunel, you fucking weirdo.